Welcome to a new video. In this video, I want to show you the new EmotionY 11 that arrived on my Mate 30 Pro here, which is the Chinese model. So it could be that in Europe or in the United States, this update will arrive a little bit later. The first thing that we want to show, or the first thing that I want to show you is the smart always-on display. It's a new feature of the EmotionY 11 update. You can see this is the new, actually it's the old one, but now if I tap in here you can see it is animated. So this is new. So we have animated always on displays. We can configure them under our settings, under home screen and wallpaper, always on display and display style. Here we can choose between various different categories like images, graffiti, artistic ones which are new, analog ones as you can see here, and we have digital ones here as well. And then if we want to get more, we can click on the more button, or we can get a list of my AODs as well. And you can see some of them have this little icon, this little symbol here. And if I click on this, you can see that they have some animation effects, just like the artistic ones have, for example, this artistic movement of the object here. And also what you will notice, they are showing the current time here. I'm not sure if this was there in EmotionY 10.1. And you can see here some new animation effects for the always on display, various different ones, and very nice, very cool, a little bit subtle, but still very cool, like this astronaut here or this flower, which is like opening up pretty nicely. Then the next thing that you will notice is the effects have been improved, so to say. So you can see also when I unlock the device that all the elements flow into the desktop, which is new. And all the effects here, if I want to switch between applications, all these effects are also slightly different. And also the quick toggles, you can see also when I drag down here, it has the subtle nice effect. And also the quick toggles have nice little animation effects now when I change certain things. Some of them were already there with 10.1 but have been redefined for version 11. The next thing is also not completely new but improved version of multi-window. So if I open up an application here and I want to open up a second application, just like for example the browser, I can now drag it down here. This works now with more applications. So I had issues with AntennaPod before, but this is now working without any problems in EmotionY 11. The same goes for YouTube, I think that had problems with. And of course you also have the option to open up a third application in a floating window like this. But you can see here already that this floating window has a different size because there's a new feature which allows me to resize the window. So I can resize it as big or as small as I want to, and this is the smallest version for the calculator. And another thing is like I can open up not only one floating window but a second floating window, for example for files, which will open up in a new window. And you can see that the calculator has now a nice little symbol here, and I can move this symbol around wherever I want to. I can also drag it to the trash to close it. And of course I have a minimize button which is also new now. If I tap on this, it will minimize into this view. If I click on this, I get a nice little overview of the open windows. I can close them or I can switch between them. So I can switch here. As you can see, if I have two different applications open in a floating window, I can switch between them. And this is how it looks like with free open application. Now if I click on here, I have to choose. And the same goes if I minimize it, I have now three different windows. When we are going to Notepad, let me go into full screen. And a nice little option that I have here, if I create a new note and I have a photo of something, just like for example this booklet of the Huawei FreeLace, if I click on gallery, I can say now scan document. And if I click scan document, it will open up the camera application. It will detect the document. I can take the snap and I can say okay, this is correct. It cut out the document pretty nicely in this view. But what I have now also is the possibility to extract the text out of this document, at least if it's not handwritten text, but text like this, like on brochures or on paper. I can just simply click click on this and say extract text, and it will then start extracting the text. And as you can see here, various different languages that it can detect and extract text to. So I think this is Japanese and Korean and others, Chinese somewhere should be also there. This it didn't detect, so there are some texts that it cannot detect yet. I think it's Arabic, which it cannot detect, but Russian it can detect as well. German it can detect, English as well, of course. So this is working pretty nicely for detecting texts in the Note application. And then, of course, there are some things that I cannot show you right now, just like, for example, changes in the vibration. So if you go into the settings and we go into sounds and vibrations, you can see that these look a little bit different here. So we have now sound, vibration and silent. And you can also see if I go to my desktop here, if I tap, the volume slider has been redesigned. There's no toggle to switch between the various modes anymore, which is a little sad, I would say. So you have to go in here and then you can switch between sound, vibration and silent mode. And you have a little bit more structure here. You can show more, of course, but by default they are hidden, those not so much in use volume sliders. Then you have also volume control gestures, like I showed you, left and right, that you can use and configure here. You have a sound booster and more settings. But what is pretty nice that I cannot show you right now is if you have a ringtone set, just like I have the Yola ringtone set for from SafeSOS, for example, it will vibrate in the same rhythm of this ringtone. So if you have a vibration alarm on, it will still vibrate in this rhythm of this music, which is pretty nicely done. So rhythmic ringtones, it's called. And we have some other options here as well. Like, for example, what you would notice is on your desktop, there should be a new icon called Me Time, which allows you to use Me Time. It's depending on the region. So some regions have it. Germany is, for example, in there where I have my Huawei ID, so I can use Me Time now in Germany as well to contact people with HD video calls or voice calls. And there should be also encrypted texts as well, which is nice. Then another little change is the AI subtitles. You can find it in settings somewhere. I think it should be under Huawei Assistant. AI subtitles under Huawei Assistant AI Voice. And there, if you turn this on, let's toggle this on, it has the possibility to detect spoken text or text that has been played back by the device itself. As you can see here, it is detecting what I'm saying right now. And this works not only for spoken text that I say, for example, in English, also for people who speak Chinese, it can also detect the text in Chinese as well. And this works not only for picking up stuff from the microphone, but also from picking up stuff from media that I play back on the device itself. Let's turn it on again. What I want to show you is like detecting something playing in the background.
New version of SafeSOS 3.4.0.22. The early access version of the 3.4 update for SafeSOS, and it comes with.
So you can see it detected something. I'm not sure if it is very correct. I think picking up stuff from the microphone when I'm talking is much better. But what you can do is long press here and you can save the text content as a note. And what is missing right now, what I would like to have, is like automatic translation as well. So I didn't find a way to automatically translate it. But what I can do is like save it into a notepad and then translate it, because there's a new translation feature available as well, which is not only for translating notes, just like, for example, we can go into our notepad application and I have this Chinese Japanese text here and have the option to translate it. And you can see I can use then various different translation tools, just like Google Translate, what I have here, and others that I can use for translation. Or I have a new translation option. Not sure if it's available globally, but at least on this Chinese version it's available. I can press and hold here with two thumbs. It will scan the text, and I have the option to translate the screen. And if I translate the screen, it will take a screenshot and then start translating the text that you can see here. And as you can see here, it was translating right now from auto detection to English. As you can see here, it's trying to translate quick guide, quick start guide. It didn't detect everything, but it is working pretty nicely. I used it for translating web pages, for example, that I could not read that were in Chinese. So this is working pretty nicely when it comes to translating texts. Then there in the app gallery, not in the app gallery, in the photo gallery, there's a new feature. Let me open it up. There's a new feature, and let me show you the thing like this. Create under the Discover tab, you have the option to create create a story or create a video from scratch. If you create a video from scratch, you can choose some video files that you want to include, just like here, those video files. I can click on create, and now it starts playing back, and I have a new video editor here which allows me to edit this stuff. Of course, 10.1 had also this video editor, but this one has a few more options, just like export a frame and cut the video. You have in between videos the option to have an overlay effect, a blur effect, fuse effect, up effect, and so on, to change between various different clips. So this is possible here, and you can apply it to all if you want to. You can add new files as well. You have some filters available as well, and some music that you can add here. You can edit the audio, you can cut the music, you can delete it or add it, and you have the option to add a title as well, which is a bit animated. If I say here title, for example, hit OK, and here subtitle, and hit OK and start playing this back. You can see there's a nice little effect. So I can do simple video editing now within the gallery. And then we have the blurred app previews. If you have an application that is locked, it will only create a blurred image in the app overview. And of course, also when you have screen projector plugged in, either via USB-C or you use the wireless transmission to a screen projector, you can turn off notifications, so the notifications will not turn on the projection of your screen, which is pretty nice, and will only appear on your main screen on your phone itself. So this is also a privacy feature which is integrated here. And I think those are all of the features. Of course, lasting smoothness. So Huawei is like also telling you about that this will run smoothly longer term, which is also something I cannot prove or disapprove right now. But what I can tell you is that this is running pretty smoothly, and I like the new effects, I like the new features. It's a minor update despite this big version number update. In general, I would say it is a good improvement, and I'm very interested in what you have to say to this new version. Maybe I missed some new interesting feature out that you discovered already. You can write it down in the comment section, and otherwise just like and subscribe. That's everything for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Until the next time, bye.